Let's look into day two of this rookies mini camp. And I would tell you, this is just an observation. And we hear good news about Simi. And we hear good news about Jabril Cox as well. These guys being able to make plays and these sorts of things. One of the observations that I want you guys to pay a close attention to, the coaching staff, how they're training. And they're very hands-on with these rookies. And look at this guy right here. That's Big Bo. Bohana, big physical guy that's going to play down inside. They're going to line him up right over the center, and he's going to get that job done. He's wearing number 98, and you guys used to that number, right? Watch how you just rip and release, man. That's what we want, pushing that pocket back and being able to create that type of temperaments, that type of pressure. And watch how he is striking everything. Watch how he gets off his stance, keeping everything square, center of gravity low. Push everything back. That's how you want to jam right up in there. Create that pressure right there. That is fantastic. I love it. Rip and get to the quarterback. That's what we want to see. And this is the thing. Dan Quinn, Coach DQ, hand on hand, working with his particular defensive front. We've been saying this. Coaches need to showcase their talent and bring forth their ideal and philosophy. We didn't see Mike Nolan do this last season. And this drill right here, working on disengagement, getting up field, keeping the pad levels low, and keeping that elbow into the inside. These drills goes a long way. I believe that these players understand and will appreciate the coach showcasing and saying, okay, this is what I did to elevate such and such player, and when I coached him, and this is how you can fit right in to my philosophy. Watch, keep that elbow tucked inside, not having your elbows wild, and getting up field shooting. Remember, he's going to play that three tech, and he's going to play on the side of the B gap, not the A gap. So we like seeing that from the inside. And this is Nayshon Wright. I love the small technicalities and the nuances that they're teaching these young DBs. And you see Al Harris in the mix saying, okay, yes, you're a physical big guy. Just look at that. That's Al Harris right there teaching these DBs up. How, watch that inside arm. Keep the inside arm straight. And watch Kevin Joseph. He's going to knock that inside arm out. He's playing the wide receiver situation. And Nayshon, he's playing the DB. So it's two trainings all in one. Watch the disengagement. Get there. Get around. That's what I want to see. He's teaching these guys. Use that inside arm. Redirect. Push that thing inside. Hit the shoulder. Hit the inside of that shoulder right there. Right under the armpit. They won't call holding. Jab right there. And it's up to Joseph to release and knock that down. There's a wide receiver. That's extra movement. That's slowing down the wide receiver. These are techniques that teaching the young DBs how to create pressure and move them off their marker. That's the name of the game. Get there, get that arm on that shoulder pad on the inside. All right, this is Simi Fehoku. I think that he will bring a lot to the table. Dak Prescott reached out to him when he was drafted and pretty much said, let's get into some work. And he's hungry for it, 6'4", good top speed. I like him at the top of his route, running some sharp routes here. I like seeing this, the nuances that this kid is able to bring to the table. When we thinking about a wide receiver in general, creating space, what they can do in the top of the route, how can they get separation, are they good off of their releases? These are things that we look for. And he got one of those things that you just can't create in the lab. That's God-given talent. That's 6'4" height, being able to grab the ball and pull it out of the sky. That is why he's such a valuable piece right here as a rookie. How can he transpose what he learned in college over to the NFL on the pro level? We got a long way to go. The offseason is long. Nevertheless, you want to be able to see whether or not these guys can retain the information that you coached about, when that you coached up, and see if they can pick up this stuff when it's time for training camp. Iron sharpen iron, steel sharpen steel. Let's figure this out, Cowboy Nation. That's been my time. I really thank you all for yours. And remember, you're listening to nothing but the best. Go Cowboys.